Good afternoon, beautiful souls. How are you all doing out there today? I am popping on to give some guidance and I'm going to do it slightly different. I've decided that I'm going to deliver just one card onto here and then I will do the rest with a longer video onto YouTube. I felt that, you know, sometimes we're not in the mood for sitting there listening to one big long video, and so that's what I'm going to do and see if that works. Might not, I don't know, who knows, but I felt that that was a more swifter way and I feel quite in alignment with that one, so we will see what happens. That's not to get everybody to go onto YouTube, that's just the fact that I'm just trying to utilize what I've got, the platforms, and trying to share my time so that I can do what I need to do, as they say, on each one. Professionally? Oh, that's the right word. Anyway, I am going to use these cards. I'm going to use Adoring Virtue Angel Therapy Oracle cards. I have already shuffled the cards and I have already picked one to allow this to go a little bit on a more of a prompt read rather than, you know, delay my tactics any further. And with that, I have chosen, or they have chosen, have you asked your angels for help with this? Look how beautiful colours they are. So for me, if I was looking for the colour side of things, automatically I'm guided with the reds and the oranges. So I'm looking at this is more of the root of the issue. Have you asked for help? On the bottom of this card, it says your angels want to help you with this situation. However, they require your permission before they can intervene in your free will choices. So, you know, this doesn't just necessarily mean ask your angels. This is asking for help all around you, isn't it? It's not just an angel that you do need to ask for. And some of you might not believe in angels. So, you know, it's not just that. It's like, do you ask for help? I don't. Well, I do, but not regularly. And generally speaking, I know for myself, I will kind of, by the time I get to that stage of asking for help, I've already fallen down and scuffed my knees. So I have to learn from this, and my independence sometimes gets in the way. It's like, I can do it, but at the same time, you know, just being honest, and sometimes it just doesn't help. You know, sometimes we can be a bit proud. I've wrote this down as well so that I don't forget what I wanted to say. We can be a bit proud to ask, or it feels it's a weakness. Is it a weakness? Of course it's not a weakness. But it is a weakness if you don't ask, because at the end of the day, as I say, I get there and I'm ended up with scuffed knees. So, you know, get in there before that happens. Don't allow that to become a weakness, because it will become, and it will stop you in your tracks if you don't, you know, ask for help. You know, as I've put here, how are those around you able to help ease the burden if they don't know, or you just don't let them in? And that's another thing. Just don't let that person in. They're not mind readers. We can all be crystal ball, and, you know, as we do and what we do. But you do need to ask, and that is the biggest way forward. It's ask. So as with these, as I do with all of these, that's how I feel and what I feel that's guided in. And now I'm going to read from the book, because I feel sometimes that also helps, because it allows people to pick up things that I might not have said or I don't necessarily feel is needed. So here we go. This card indicates that you've been going it alone, trying to single-handedly find answers and solutions. All the while, your angels hover nearby awaiting the moment when you give them the go-ahead signal so they can help you. You drew this card because the angels want to assist you with this situation, but they can only do so if you give them permission. The angels are available to you right now to answer your questions, give you guidance, and speed your manifestations. It's true that God and the angels already know what you need. However, because God created you and everyone with free will, heaven can only intervene if you give them permission. It doesn't matter whether you ask for help aloud, in writing form, silently, or even what words you choose. What matters is that you ask. If you're unsure of what to ask for, or are concerned about asking for the wrong thing or requesting less, then let's God's will, then ask heaven to help you with clarity and courage. And so we've got our second card. Our second card is Goddess. So, Goddess, look at the beautiful colours in that. Isn't that just lovely? Absolutely lovely. I'm directed straight away to the colours in the background. I'm looking at your confidence, the yellow, the solar plexus, the yellows, the oranges, but mainly the yellows is shining out for me. Your strength, your confidence. Stand tall, be up there, be good in loving yourself. So I have, as I've written down on here, stand tall, embrace who you are. Don't compare yourself to others. Look in that mirror and enjoy who is looking back at you. Love, nurture and smile. This will gain you confidence, shining your light brightly. Most importantly, take time to look after you. You are no use or help to others if you haven't looked after number one. That's so true, isn't it? So true. But that in itself, when you look at all the different bits in there, there is this nurturing. You've got this sleeping. You've got this musical side, so having fun. It all looks very sedentary in the back. It's good about this time of day, isn't it? The waters all look calm. It looks very, very peaceful. But at the same time, this is because you're honouring yourself. You're looking after yourself. We're going to go to the book, as we do, just to check to see what else is in there that I might have missed. Express your divine feminine energy. Embraces its magical intuition and nurturing qualities. This card speaks of a need for sacred female energy, which brings gifts such as intuition, nurturing and artistic expression. Perhaps you've been spending too much time thinking or engaging in creativity. God, said that wrong, didn't I? Void work. If so, then this card is your signal to move your body and dance and express your intuitive, artistic and nurturing side. You're also guided to call on your benevolent female deities for help with the situation you're inquiring about. You can call upon, I can't say that. I'm going to leave this in because I'm not recording again. But this is the beloved Hindu goddess who helps with abundance. I might be saying that completely wrong. Jeez, right, I need to actually. I will have a look at that afterwards, but I'm going to leave this in. Brigitte, the Celtic goddess of Celtic. What is going on today? The Celtic goddess of healing and courage. Mother Mary, the saint who guides our children. Athena, the Greek. Oh, my dear Lord. Goddess of wisdom. The Egyptian goddess Isis, who helps women juggle home, family, or any of the thousands of other trustworthy and sacred feminine deities. Grecian goddess of wisdom. The Egyptian goddess of Isis. Anyway, those. Within every woman are three parts of the goddess maiden. Inner child, at times pure and at other times adventurous or bold. Mother, which is nurturing qualities. And the matriarch, the teacher. Men have analogues, inner qualities of the lad, the dad and the patriarch. It's important to express each of these three parts daily. This helps to balance playfulness with work and relationships. Spend time each day expressing all three characteristics. And notice how much more energised and balanced you feel. And on that note, I need to improve my reading. Or at least I read them before I start doing them on air. Because, I sound like I need reading lessons. I'm not disputing anything on reading lessons, but, Anyway, let's stop that one there, because I think I need to erase some of that. And third card is crystals. Look at that. That's so pretty, isn't it? The crystals. So I'm guided with the colours again on that, and with the waters, how this is going to balance your emotions. I wrote down, going forward, bring crystals around you. Let them support you. Go with what draws your attention energetically. They are connecting with you vibrationally. They will balance your emotions and soothe your soul. Absolutely wonderful. Can't beat So I'm going to read from the book and let's have a little look on there. So we have the energy of crystals to support you and help with your present situation. This card, a dual meaning with respect to the term crystal. One or both may apply to you, which you'll know by your inner reaction while reading these words. First, this card represents the crystals of the mineral kingdom. These powerful beings emit, transmute and magnify energies. For example, clear quartz can increase your psychic ability or clarity. Black obsidian stone is an effective protector. Pink rose quartz opens your heart to love. And purple amethyst raises your spiritual vibrations. This card is asking you to work with crystal energy as you feel guided to, by yourself, with the help of a crystal practitioner, or by conducting crystal healings for others. The second meaning relates to people who are considered crystalline themselves. That is, that they are quiet and sensitive, transmitters of healing energy. Most crystals are young children, so this card could indicate that you are parenting or working with a crystal child. You may also have crystal characteristics yourself, particularly if you are gentle, soft-spoken and a lover of nature. I mean, crystals on themselves are absolutely stunning. It doesn't even matter if you don't know which one to go for. You just allow them to choose you. So you go into a shop and you'll be guided. You'll feel drawn to a particular. It might even just be because it's sparkly, but at the same time, it will have a hidden meaning behind that, because energetically, vibrationally, they're connected with your vibration. Well, now, and yeah, so that's that's enough of that. So that's the cards for today. I'm going to be doing a lot of cutting and editing because I've made quite a few moves, which I'm not going to show you.